Mila. Thank you.
Thank you so much. What a nice presentation, right? Thank you. And, well, I'm coming from Temple Ridge. You've heard a little bit about who I am. And I just want to tell you that I'm deeply passionate about helping people like you, people who take charge, who say, I am independent. I know what I can, and I know I can supply services and products for the public from my own experience. This is amazing. And this is my passion because, you know, we often, as entrepreneurs, and I'm like my lifelong entrepreneur, we are isolated, right? We are isolated from what is happening and doubts and worries and whatever comes our way. And my passion is, and I see it as my life's purpose, is to share what I know, to give you the empowerment, the inspiration that is within you, the power that was there when you created your business, the dreams that were there. And I would like to, with today my intention is completely to make you move back in your mind in that moment where your business did not exist yet out there, but it was here. And everything was created in your mind. You lived in your store before you rented the space. And what we forget, usually, we move away from this visioning leader's position because the business has three levels, right? So there is the leader, the visionary, where you started. Then there is the manager, who is juggling whatever is there and telling everyone what is to do. And then, very often, if you are self-employed, you are even working like hands-on. So you should have then all three levels in your daily life. But what is happening, we stay in the level of manager and worker, and the visionary who created that business is gone. And my intention today is just deliver some thoughts, insight, and of course I have two very practical, actionable tools for you. I promised you that I'll give you something to reduce stress and increase productivity. Usually, we would think, okay, if I increase productivity, I will have more stress and less time. But if you start to think about, and I have on my promotion double-double, which I heard somewhere and somebody said, you can double your money, you can double your time off. I thought, impossible. How can I double my money? That means I need to work more and have more time off. It's not a possibility, but it is. It is. When we start to ask questions. So, before I really dive deep into the presentation today, I need to watch my time because I can speak for days. Yes, and I do very often. I do retreats and stuff like that. So before we go there, I'd just like to tell you a little bit who I am, why I think I can tell you something. And basically what I did in my life, and you can hear I'm not born Canadian, I was born in Czech Republic, then I immigrated to Germany and to a country where I did not know, not even the language. I lived there, have my family there. I started a small business with my husband at that time. And after my marriage went away, then I went into the corporate arena and worked there from the very bottom in the retail of a fashion stores, as starting well, I was applying for area manager, but what they did for us, and this is really good, we had to start on the salesperson level, basically in the storehouse, to learn the whole procedure of operation. And after that, first move up into the area management. So I managed about 16 stores, and each one of them made about 1.5 million. And my task there was, we had nice sheet, and I was checking these stores, and it started with, okay, outside, window dressing, sales personnel, store, and so on, presentation. And when I came here, well, okay, what I did then, I believe that person can do what they love to do and make money with it. So I thought, I really love travel. And friend invited me to Canada, and I really loved Canada. And so I thought, well, you know, I could do something for a living, have fun. I want to travel, so I started guiding company. This is how I came over here, with a really small boutique guiding company. And cut a long story short, after my husband passed away, I needed, living in Table Ridge, I needed make money. So I started, and my life changed like this. I had several businesses. I always transformed with the mindset, what can I do right now with what I have? And because I was self-employed, and you know, if you are in a position of self-employed solopreneur, everything hangs on you. And in my case, my mom became bedridden. My whole life went away, and I had to restore my income and my business. So I did it three times in Tumblr, and of course, the economy goes up and down. And then I realized we have internet, economy is down, so I started to do online business. I spent money on learning how to do online business, and I'm very passionate about telling everyone, if you live in a remote community, use the online, make yourself aware, because there is no way back from social media and online presence and so on. Okay, so I started to import and use online businesses. My online businesses generate money. Then I closed my brick and mortar because my mom passed away. Everyone is in heavens. So I wanted to do what I love to do, which is independence. And so I started to go into consulting. And I got certified as a transformational coach in 2015. And after 1 year of retirement, I couldn't stand it anymore. So I'm back into consulting. So this is where I am coming from. And I know what you are going through. I've been there, and I know there is a way how you can transform your results, 100%. And if you want double your business and double your time off, you can do that. The only thing that it takes is to want it. Okay, so now starting, I would like to guide you through these few pages, and I would like to make you work. And I need to watch my time here, so I'm still good. So on the very first page, I would really like to give you this. The first part is here, the quote, entrepreneurship is the ultimate path to freedom, growth, and joy. This is how I see you as an entrepreneur, and I see you as the person who has the potential to take control and create the life they want to live. As you started your business, you started your business not to have a business. You started your business to have the life of your dreams. And I'll come later to that, how crucial that thought is. So, but this little quote, this little statement down here, the first Canadian mentor that I ever had is a gentleman from Dawson Creek, actually. And he sent me one when I was down, my husband passed away, I did not know where to get my money from. I went and I asked organization of support and possibilities. I was looking for a mentor because I believe like two brains are more than one. And he sent me in one email this quote. And I just changed the title, and because this is from me to you. I want you to tell you this. One of the most impressive characteristics of entrepreneurs is that they simply refuse to surrender to the forces of a poor economy. Hello. They are carving a living out of their environment using their knowledge, their skills, and their unique creativity. They are a proud, tough group of individuals, and you are one of them. Remember this. It's amazing, powerful position you have by being your own boss and entrepreneur. So now to the presentation, where I'm coming back to this double-double, which sounds like, okay, it's kind of our statement, right? But I would like to explain you the system that many, many people are not really aware of, that we are responsible for the results. And I don't mean it like blaming, I've done that. That's a power. We create results. And this RAT, RAT, I created that acronym because it's so nice. And I should go on the other side, right? So, I would like to guide you mentally to follow this path, how we create our results. So what is right now in your life, this is your result. And I put it this way. This is your result. Where comes your result from? Before you sat here, entered the room. Hard work, where's it? Who was, yeah, hard work. Which is action. Action. You took action that led you to this result. You said yes to our beautiful manager's email invitation to attend this luncheon. You said yes. You could say no, right? So you said yes, you took action, you are here, the result is you have nice lunch. Yes, and we are very grateful for that. But where came your action from? Of course, from the email. But it came from evaluation. You got the email, and in your mind, lit up. Do I want it, or I don't want it? You had a choice in your mind, choose the thought that will be beneficial for you. The action that you came is just a result of the thought, because you could say, no, so you won't be here. So this is really crucial, and this is how you created your business. Before you rented a store, bought the equipment, or whatever, before you took the action, you had your business in your mind as the thought. You were already behind your counter thinking about your clients sitting while sitting still in your comfy chair in the living room. So I like to guide you to that place of understanding that you have choice in your mind. Once you make your opinion, the action is automatic. And this is the second page. And, you know, I was watching my time again, 35. I'm intrigued by the millions of years of wisdom, of human wisdom, that still did not root it and sprout it. So on top of this page with TAR, there is a quote from my very, 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 very favorite person. Roman Emperor, you must think about this. This person, there is one of his quotes, but when I read another one, he said, person's life is what his opinion makes out of it. That means, if I think I can, I can. If I think I can't, I can't. So that's a nice quote from Henry Ford, who said the same. When every one of his engineers were telling him he cannot have 8V motors, engine. Impossible, they said to him. Impossible. His quote is, if you can, if you think you can. If you think you can't, you can't. Defeat happens in the mind. This is what I would like you to open a door to your mind. Make you that realize you have the choice to think what you want. You don't need to accept that the economy is down. I'm living in Tumblr. There are people who are really not seeing any future, maybe a little bit now. But when we went down 2 years ago, I received phone calls from people who knew me from the tourism business who wanted to start business with me. There are people who see opportunities, and you can be one of them. You can transform your life where you want it to be, not living from the conditions and allow the conditions dictate you, what you are, what you think you can do, but choose what you want to do and go after it. So under the big picture, there are these three levels, how I see you in your business. And if you start to move back always to the mental part of your project and create a picture of your project before you take action, then you will move forward where you want to be, which requires, of course, planning, and which requires you must know what projects you want to create on your own. So let's see. Oh, I'm good. 35. So I would like to really, how should I put it? If I could shake you, I would shake you. But these two levels, manager and worker, this is where we are captured. Because there is hands-on work. There are clients coming in. There is a statement from the bank coming in. There is stuff coming in. And we don't have time, we think we don't have time. Maybe we don't even think if there is the option. We must move back up to the vision and say, okay, what do I want? And then line up all your projects with that vision. And I would like to close with that, or just flip the chart. Before I go further, you can see my passion. So I gave you on your table this little card. If you like to have a free consultation about what you can do about your business, grow, improve, whatever it is, then write your phone number in there, leave it here or give it to me, and I'll give you a call and I'll give you a free strategy session. This is my gift to you. So now going back to coming from this, having a vision. If you turn around this page, there is a quote, unfold your full potential and live life of purpose, prosperity, and peace because you were born to thrive. If a carrot can live and unfold its full potential so it can serve the humanity, then we have the same right. And within you, you know exactly what you want. You know exactly what you long for. You know exactly what you don't like and what you like to improve. So as entrepreneurs, I always see you as one. You are your business. If you are well, your business is well. If you are not well, your business is suffering. So there is no separation between you and your business. Therefore, you must create a vision, and maybe you had it, maybe you have it. If you have a clear vision why you are running a business and what is your exit strategy when you're sitting, I don't know, your ideal picture, when you look back at your entrepreneurial situation and lifespan and feel this complete satisfaction with you, what is it? Why are you running your business? You don't want to pass out behind the counter. That's not the end of life. You envision, I'm quite sure of that. You build your business to have the life of your dreams, to be in power, in charge of your life, have the relationships you love, have you know, the lifestyle, the freedom, choose, the money, life's work, fulfill yourself in that. I met few people here, people who put their passion into their business. They fulfill, realize themselves. I'm so proud of you guys. But understand that there's 360 degrees to you. It's not only the business. It's your relationship or relationships. Of course, it's the bank account, right? But it's also your body and well-being and health. So you don't need to sacrifice one of those things if you have a complete vision. So I would then suggest, just for you, there is a little line. If you would rate yourself, your satisfaction with your life in 300 degrees in the area of health, finance, relationships, and work or business, give yourself a rating. It's just, and it's not about to, you know, poor me, it's just about know where you are, because unless you know where you are, you cannot go where you want to go, okay? So this is just for you, self-assessment, health, finance, relationships, and work or business. And then you can take the sheet home, because usually to discover what you really want from life takes more than 5 minutes. And then there is a little, say, follow-up. If it would be rated on 10, if your wealth and health and finances and relationships will be full 10, and you will be fully satisfied, yes, that's me. What it means? How much time will you spend with your wife or husband or children? How much time will you spend on yourself? There are really many things in this little mosaic. So this is for you. You can spend some thoughts. And I know I'm doing lots of work about people creating the complete vision, planning a strategy. I know that figuring out what I really want from life, it's not an easy task. It needs constant attention because it changes. So, and what I like to give you, well, I don't have a bigger thing here, all-time bestseller, Seven Habits of Highly Successful People. You probably know it, Stephen Covey. The first habit is be proactive. Okay, be proactive. The second habit is start with the end result in mind. You need to know your vision. You need to know how you want to go out of your business in the way that you will be a winner. Do you have exit strategy? When I started my business, actually I lost money. And when I'm talking now with other, you know, entrepreneurs, no one will tell you when you do your business plan, you need to have your exit strategy. And that's the crucial thing. You need to know how long you want to run your business. You need to know why you're running, how much money you want to have, what is the net worth you want to create. You need to know clearly where you're going. And when you have it, maybe 10 years, 5 years, 3 years, whatever it is, then you reverse engineer and say, okay, in 3 years I need to be here. In 12 months, I'm going to be here. And then you structure your quarters down to month and week. This is how you reach whatever you want. You need to have a plan, and you need to be proactive. Number one, Stephen Covey. What you also need is another, it's not old, Simon Sinek is just really a current teacher. who studied many big companies like Apple and so on while they are still alive, and what's the reason? And this three-letter word, is the key to failure, it's the key to progress, it's the key to success. You must be on fire in order to transform your results. It means you must stop to behave the way you behave now and establish new habits, the success habits of the person you want to become. And it's not an easy task because we have established system of habits that are running our life. The way we are driving our car without even thinking about it, there are many other paradigms, processes that are running our life, and they are creating the current results. So to change the results, you might have a good reason. And to make money, it's not a good reason. It's too weak. But if you put your reason to, I want to bring my kids to college, I want to take my wife, travel the world, I don't know what. It must be enough strong reason that will allow you to leave the comfort zone of where you are right now, which is creating the results you see around yourself, the bank account, the relationships, your house, whatever it is. You create it based on the habits you have taken daily. To change it, you must become a different person. That means establish, train yourself into new habits. This is why I'm a mindset trainer, because here, it starts in the mind. So it's the mind, not the how. Usually we know what we want, and then we immediately jump into how, and because there are so many obstacles, we step back and say, oh, pity, can't do that. That's the wrong approach. If I say, I want this, why do I want it? Because it's important to me to put my kids into college and I will do everything that I can do to generate the money. There is different fire behind, guys. So you need to have a good reason for your business. And I would like to inspire you to think about why you are running your business. 45, let's see how we are doing. Very good. Okay. I'm just browsing through, but what I said before, if you want to have more of support and my services, of course I'm coaching and consulting, give me a call or put it on the card and I'll call you and we go from there. Because I know what it entails. So, next page. We have a nice, very nice quote up there from Jim Rohn. You are the average of the five people you spend the most time with. I don't know if it's true. It's just out there. But what I know for sure, that if you want to transform your results, you need to connect with people who either know how to do that or who already live it. People who will support you. People who do not believe in bad economy, people who are doers, people who will lift you up and not commiserate with you. They will not allow you to complain about what's bad and why you can't do things. They will help you to find ideas how you can change it. And like I said, I don't know if this average of five people is true. This is basically here for you, this little list. Also make you think, who would be the people you think they live the life you want to live, or you think they figure that out? It can be also different people who mastered specific areas of life. If you know somebody who transformed their weight and health, that's the person you want to be with. But don't talk about economy, just ask how to transform your well-being. Or you find people who are 360 degrees on the path. These are the people. They might be not immediate neighborhood, But hey, we have internet. Google it. Go on it. Follow these people. You need to hook up to their way of thinking, because how we think creates the results. Their way of thinking create the results you want. You need to check out how they think. And once you know, then you are in good company. And I put myself here, and please, you can do that. Number one, who is the number one person you talk most?
Yourself.
Yeah, hello. And how bad we are to ourselves. You know, walking by the window, oh, I should sell, you know, a few pounds could go down, right? So we talk instantly, constantly in our mind. We pass a person and we judge the person. We see a person, we think. We think about, my husband left it. Let's see this beautiful scene. My husband smashed the door when he left this morning, okay? So I spend my time about what's wrong, right? And oh, maybe, you know, maybe he's mad because I did this, or maybe it's in the workplace. He comes home and I'm already half down and said, what was wrong this morning? And he doesn't know anything. I created my story in my mind during the day that doesn't have anything to do with the reality. So somebody is laughing. Hello. Everyone does it. We all do it. When I was in Germany, that was a lesson, a little thing. A person came in my store, and at that time I was selling electronics. And he looks bad, right? You would say, like, you know, somebody who got off the street. And then he wants to see this big camera and, you know, a couple of thousand dollars. And okay, well, then you go and you carefully, you know, present it. Really, at that time, I did not pay the attention as I would to a person who comes in with a suit, with a nice, you know, suitcase in his hand or her hand. And that was a big lesson to me. This person, after my not so good presentation, grabs in his pocket, rolls out a bundle of $100 with a little elastic band around it. So how much is it? Well, then I realized that this person is actually a very esteemed artist. I did not know it. And I judged by his pure appearance. And I stopped. That was a big lesson. I felt ashamed for myself. And I really now understand what is happening. Of course, no one is perfect. But just to become aware of what is happening in our mind is a milestone ahead toward what you want and toward well-being. Because now we all know how important is the thinking, how influential to the physical well-being. Psychosomatics, people get sick just from bad thoughts. Okay, so that's my little gift to you. So start with yourself. You have 525,000 minutes in the next 12 months. And it's a big investment. You never get it back. And it's about how you invest it. Will you complain? Will you socialize with people who put you down? Will you justify and seek for some kind of excuses why you can't do what you want to do? Or will you brush it away and say, that's not me anymore, because I know I can either complain or I can sit down and ask myself, what can I do to improve the situation? So I promised you a tangible, very tangible wasn't we? Okay. So these five people, if you do that, you will immediately see that there are people who think differently, and then you can learn a lot of them. I missed this beautiful page, which is a power tool. I learned that from Brendan Bouchard, 5 minutes to go. And when I learned to teach online, I put my first book on Amazon. I learned how to do that. He's in personal development and he is in online marketing, the number one, the coach of high performance. And I learned with him in the High Performance Academy. And what I'm using every day is this power tool that will improve your productivity and completely reduce stress. So it's called One Page Productivity Sheet. And what I do, I tell you, it takes for like 30 minutes every day, maybe less. What is required, you need to know where you're going. So I assume that you have your vision of your life and you know what this year should bring you in your business, in revenue, or whatever you are going. So you're starting with reminding yourself on your long-term goal. This is what I'm doing this year. Then, yeah, assuming as business people, you have it chucked down. That means this quarter I'm doing this, this quarter I'm doing it, this quarter I'm doing it, and so on. And then you have short-term goals. So you know what you are doing this month, you know what you're doing this week. For the goal up here, to double your revenue, let's say, for example. So you have the short-term goals. You write it in, you know it, it's in your head. The next is really important. People to connect, people I'm waiting on. This is the only thing. When you open your email, you do not scroll the 150 emails that are jumped in. You look only for the people who you are waiting on or the people you want to connect. Only thing, 5 minute thing. The next thing, you write down your priorities for the day. That means what is really the critical, your highest responsibility, or the urgency. You write your priorities and then you go in your day. And I would like to give you this. And if you are interested in reading more, there's a very nice book. It calls for dummies, but I will tell you there's lots of wisdom in there. From a lady who really studies neuroscience. And I just took this out of there. In our brain is really, really teeny tiny place, RAS, reticular activating system, that is there for a reason, that filters all the information. And whatever we put our attention on, that means, okay, I'm making whatever it is this month, I don't know, number, $100,000 revenue. I'm going for $100,000 revenue. This is my goal, short-term goal. This piece in your mind filters all information that is relevant for you to move ahead with what you are focused on. With what you are focused on. If you are focused on, my knee hurts, all the information will come there on the illnesses and whatever, and you end up on Google looking for whatever is coming out of there. Your mind is very powerful. And the most important thing is, and I would really like to read this to you, when you do your list, the RAS, this is this little part, make sure that the last thing you look at is your list of short-term goals. Your RAS helps you keep them in mind, even when you don't realize you are thinking about these goals. Your brain knows that they are important and makes note of everything that might relate to them. This is real science. This is something no one told us in the school. This is something important. If you know it, then you put your, okay, let's say, thinking of my husband, right? Don't have one, but okay. He left the home. I'm sitting here with my list. What is my last thought? Am I focused on the personal troubles? If I'm focused on the personal troubles, then I'm programming my RAS onto thinking more of personal troubles. But if I stopped and brush it away, my personal problems as entrepreneur, and say, okay, what is the substance? Why am I doing the business? What I want to achieve? What is my project right now? Then I'm going into the day with a thought of what I want to achieve. In my mind, my system will deliver the information even if I'm not consciously aware of that, even if I'm talking to the client, okay? So I don't wanna put you really into silence, but I'm quite sure that information that I just shared is not the usual you are hearing here. And unfortunately, it's not really the usual information that is taught in the school. And it's out there. So I would like to really empower you to look into it, become more curious, believe in yourself, and if you want to chat, give me a call. So, it's my pleasure. I love you all. I have a big heart for Chetwynd. There is lots of power. And that's why I really appreciate the invitation for Naomi. And I say thank you. Much success to you. Okay.